I want to move topics now and talk to you about Bitcoin. And you tweeted out last week, short GBTC. This is Bitcoin Investment Trust. You were saying short that, buy Bitcoin, because the spread here is over 40%. And I guess you expect that to close. Why?
Oh, wow. It's going to close now sooner than ever. I mean, today for a while. I think it opened this morning at possibly a 45%. And sometime during intraday, it went maybe down to 20%. I'm not exactly sure as we speak right now what it is, possibly in the 30%. But as soon as futures come on the Bitcoin market, we should see the price of the ETFs or whatever form of derivative that trades, possibly a 3% to 7% premium to net asset value versus 35%. So, yeah, it's very compelling. Whenever that spread opens up on GBTC. Now, the risk is if you short that naked without the hedge, is your short Bitcoin, and even being short Bitcoin 25-30% higher, who knows what happens over a long weekend.
What do you think these futures are going to be used for? Are they going to be used for more speculation, or do you think it is going to be downside pressure that we see? And ultimately, what's your price target on Bitcoin here? What's fair, do you think?
That's the irony of the whole thing, is it's obvious speculation, because the only alternative instead of speculation would be hedging. And no one's hedging their Bitcoins right now. There's no one who has to deliver a certain amount of Bitcoin like a commodity. It's going to be for speculation. What that does to the actual Bitcoin market, who knows? I mean, that's such a black box. It's so much easier shorting companies that lose money in the middle of a bad rotation than to try to find out how Bitcoin's going to trade in the next 3 weeks. But the GBTC, when that spread does open up, it does put the odds in your favor to short that. And if you want to buy Bitcoin or just short it, and you're short it at a, then you're short Bitcoin 30-40% higher. Depends on where the premium is.